Hello, greetings. This is Gilles Mancien. I wanted to come and say hello. Wish you a really good day. I hope you're enjoying this this wonderful day. It is this new moon actually today, a new moon in Aquarius. So it is time for breakthrough. A breakthrough is something that is unusual. It's something that and breakthroughs can happen now or they can happen throughout the whole year. For it is a year of breakthrough. In the I Ching, the breakthrough is essentially a very unusual situation where the water has raised above the treetop. So it is not something that will last, but it is something extremely unusual. So be ready for breakthrough, for no matter what astrology or anything can do. It is whenever you're ready, life will bring it to you. Bring it on immediately, as soon as you're ready. And there is no more reason to wait for anything. Life is now. So whatever you're called to do, do it now. I felt I've wasted a lot of time in my life, but it was my time to waste. But why wait? Now I'm doing it, and I'm realizing when my spirit says that this cleansing is like as soon as you do it, you will wonder why you didn't do it sooner, because it is getting to something that is far better, far more integrated. So I'm going to pull a card. I'm going to discuss a few ideas, and I'm going to speak about art a little bit. What we're seeking to do is to liberate the fire of our soul, where it's just a spark that comes and goes, in terms of the spark of light that comes and goes, but we need to turn it into a blazing fire, a blazing sun. This flame every day is different. The flame never, it's always changing. And so we want to be able to move into this flame, to let go of the form, to return to the eternal great sacred fire. We want to activate our 12 rays of Creator, our wheel of Creator wheel, the full 12 rays of Creator light, because we're working with 7 light frequencies, 7 light rays through the 7 chakras, the 7 visible frequency. But eventually we're going to be able to reintegrate the higher light frequencies, for within the white light of Creator there is all the 12 divine rays, only not in the same proportions. There is a higher rays such as opalescent, pearlescent, white, aquamarine. There is all kinds of flame within flames. There is all kinds of, but essentially there is 12 rays that will be integrating very soon. As we integrate those 12 rays, we'll move into this much more powerful Creator light of, and we'll be able to integrate, to create our life through this polychromatic experience. Also to understand, to know that any show, any entertainment, any teaching can be received positively or negatively. There is always a position that can contradict or oppose it. So filter it through your heart, for there is just a matter of test sometimes. Where do we stand in relationship to something that is being presented? Even a TV show can bring joy to someone and bring a conflict into somebody else's consciousness. It all depends on where we are. And so always filter it through your heart to see how things resonate with you in any given moment. It is important to find activities that we find that, even if it's small activities, that we can disconnect from the noise of the world, disconnect from the chaos, and to find those small moments of happiness being in the present. When I paint, I'm completely disconnected from anything that's past or future. I'm concentrated on what I'm doing. But there are many other activities, and the more we have to calm down our mind needs to be quiet in order to be able to receive. For the earth is seeking to be free from the past, present, and future, to move into this eternal moment of now, so that we can integrate this fifth dimensional reality, where we are free from past, present, future. Everything is now. Everything is, we are completely, even physical matter is no longer, we're not subservient to physical matter and physical life circumstances. And once we integrate the 5D, we will have power over all of physicality, the 3 and 4th dimension, the power of love. But when we move from 3 dimension, third dimension, which is the power of the beliefs of the senses that life is real out there, and that we understood and controlled by the ego, we move to the 4th dimension. It is, and we seek to attain the soul reality of the 5th dimension, for we already have that. We bring into every day, we bring new level of our higher self. But sometimes it is like no man's land. It is like we have to pass through, like Dante Alighieri in the Sacred Poem, the Divine Comedy, explained to us, although it's through his medieval consciousness of a Christian. It's like he has to go through the circle of hell, for he's looking for his beloved Beatrice that just died. And so he has a guide named Virgil. It's a poet from the Roman era. great poet who guide him through the circles of hell before he finds the opening and finds the light of the sun and finds the circle of purgatory that leads him eventually to his paradise. Anyway, he finds Beatrice, and at some point he rejoined her. And so it is important to let go, to pass through all the dark shadows, to go beyond, to find this place of point where we can tune into the higher frequency of spirit and light, and so where our soul resides. So it is essentially what we seek to do, to reconnect to our spiritual nature, to our etheric nature, to our astral spiritual nature, where our soul and astral body can blend and become one, and so from there we'll find our wholeness. The card of the day today is the Three of Raphael. It's a card of celebration, of intimacy, of it says you have so many reasons to party, a community of friends, good news in relationship to a relation or children. So it is all about good news. I know there is breakthroughs that are coming right up for me. But breakthroughs can come all year long. So it is important whenever we're ready, just accept this breakthrough and focus on it. Allow yourself to feel it, to know it even before it manifests. The painting behind me is called Orvanten. It is the great super universe of that we live, the seventh super universe, and the Milky Way galaxy is at the center. Our planet is here, called Urantia, on the edge of the Milky Way. And Uversa I just finished this center here. Uversa is the central world, the administrative world of this for this 1 trillion inhabited world, 100,000 local universe. It's ruled by the Ancient of Days. There is 21 Ancient of Days, and it's a 7 super universe, and ruled by 3. And there is like cluster of spiritual universities. The highest, most exciting overall sphere of cosmic sphere is the most exciting before we ascend to the central universe and paradise. We'll eventually discover that as we ascend. I'm going to pull a few cards from the Akash, and then I'm going to. So the highest wisdom for us today is the monk or the nun. It can be interpreted in two different ways. Either we need to gather our energy, not to let ourselves be distracted right now to disperse our sexual energy and our mental, our vital energy, our spirit mental energy. Or it can be to disconnect all those old patterns of believing that we need to be celibate or what to enjoy. The expansion of a sexual life. So it all depends on how you feel, how you are guided within. What we need to understand is Egypt. It is the power of the eternal life. For this pyramid was built on top of the halls of Amenti. It is a sacred knowledge. It's where the truth of eternal life has been hidden within this pyramid, and all kinds of magical technologies will also be revealed very soon. And all the secret ancient knowledge will come back to the surface it's been protected for all the pyramids were not built by men but by advanced extraterrestrials such as Thoth or the masters that without the power of levitation they could have never built those pyramids. They used the Atlantean crystal of anti-gravity in order to build those huge pyramids. Otherwise, they speculate on and they try to provide some explanation that men were like pulling those things and like woods and they like for 1,000 miles and they brought those things. But it's like no. We'll come to realize the truth. And the Sphinx is actually the guardian of the doorway of there is within the Sphinx and below the Sphinx all kinds of mystery technological treasures from Atlantis, and it guards the. It is the guardian of those technologies. Those things will not come to man's understanding until it stops doing his war, because those technologies can be used for war purposes. And so man has to be pacified before those technologies are released into the collective of humanity. What we need to do is the wish. We need to fulfill whatever our wish. It is our soul plan that is important in many sense. Sometimes we do not know our soul plan, but we have to trust and believe. And each and every day we receive revelation and we have to follow that. Also to know that whatever we wish for, we might get. So be careful what you ask for, because it will come into being. And the outcome is the scribe or the writer. It's about continue to write, taking notes. For me, it's publishing my book. Then soon I'm gonna be called to become more involved in a societal process of the political process. But I need to write a book to explain my ideas, because France is kind of blocked in into this old matrix system. But there are ideas that will liberate essentially we want to liberate the quality of life. We want people to be happy. That's the only thing that's important, to restore the environment and to create the freedom. freedom. People can have more money to enjoy life and to be more free, more prosper. That it all goes through education as well. But there is a lot of good things about France that needs to be saved and preserved. For we have one of the best health systems in the world, with free education. There is all kinds of good things in France, but there are certain things that needs to be reformed, and in order to recenter the interest towards the well-being of the people, not the well-being of the banks or the well-being of the multinationals or the well-being of the government. Those are completely they've been given way too much power to abuse the world, and so we need to. Although I'm more on the right, I'm more on the conservative center right. So I am for pro enterprise. I'm not for like left wing socialism. It's not my way of being. But I do want to reinforce the idea that the middle class has been sacrificed in order to save all those powerful corporate entities. And the middle class is really where the bastion of freedom. It is where the liberation will come once the middle class. What's happening in China also, the middle class is creating these great big economies because the middle class is growing, and there is like, so it is not the rich or the poor. Then we'll eliminate poverty, will be something that will be needed, but all things in due time. I wanted to say that I was criticizing, I don't know if I did that in English, but I wanted to speak about art. Sometimes in French, every art is very institutionalized. It means that everything goes through there's very little collectors. Private people don't collect art. It just goes through like those public organizations, and they are very, very, it's like body, you know. If you're the cousin of somebody or the nephew of somebody, then they will do that or this or that for you. But otherwise, they'll just reject you. But in many sense, my art, I know for my art, I tried when I came to France, I knocked on every door and get mostly rejected everywhere, but it's very avant-garde, and so it's normal when you're very forward, when you're very different than anything. The Cubists were rejected. The Van Gogh didn't sell a single painting in Aix-en-Provence. The director of the museum didn't want any Cézanne in his museum. He thought he was a mediocre artist. But when you see his museum, there was no other artist that could compare, that would like come to that would even come close to the genius of Paul Cézanne in his museum. So it is as an artist like Marcel Duchamp said, it is good to, you want to address the future generation more than the present generation. That's like easy it's all about marketing in the present day, present marketing. So but in many sense, I do think there is an awakening, and so I do feel like art symbolistic, art speaks about the mystery of life, will be received now. Also, there is a lot of artists that do not, I'm not criticizing, because like I said, it's a matter of test. Everybody's got the right to his own test. For it's like life is a banquet, so you eat your whatever food you like, you serve yourself and you eat, and then there's somebody that's eating something extremely that you really don't like, and he's going to eat something other, but you're afraid that it's going to spill into your plate, so you're like, oh, I don't even want that to be part of the buffet, but it's part of the buffet. There's test for everybody, but I do not care much for the taxidermy, the dead animal, the dead dolphin, the dead sharks, the skulls, the bloody things, and the bad taste, all the things that are negative, like violence and war, and all the art that treats over that. And there is a lot of artists that have never even touched a brush. They're like, they're asking somebody else to do the art for them. And for me, this is not art. When it's just a mental process, there is no soul, no spirit. So even if I have a studio where I have assistants, I will still want to paint my own work myself. And that also, when you buy art, first I was an art dealer before I became an artist, and then broker. And so the older an artist, the older a piece is, the more difficult it is to buy it. When you buy modern art, it's fairly easy, or contemporary art, because the provenance, the condition, everything. But an older older paintings, they may always have maybe problems with provenance, and they may be problems with condition. The more a painting has been restored, the less interest it becomes, because the work of the original artist has been diffused. And then also some of those old Renaissance artists were painting with huge studios where they had like tons of assistants, like in Rubens. We know that when Rubens only did the design of his painting, then people came to paint like his assistant, and then he would just come back and do the faces, the hands, and the feet. The only paintings that totally made from his own hand was was the portrait of Helen, his mistress. Same thing with Andy Warhol. Collectors will probably prefer to buy the painting from the 60s when he was painting himself. Then in the 70s, he had a lot of money and he asked people to paint it for themselves. But it's not the same. It's much cheaper. It's like, you know, it's like offset, you know, where I spend millions of dollars in something that just comes out of that wasn't even touched by the artist. So, but I think there is a great deal of new values that will be. There's going to be a lot of course, as an art dealer, when I reopen my gallery, I'm going to be able to assert my own taste, but I have to be careful also to be kind. For if people have different tastes than I am, they collect portraits of dictators or whatever, like, it's their choice, but it's not my taste. I bought like a Ku Klux Klan or like those racist things, and it's like there's some famous artists that are very, very well, but they defend values that are completely opposing to what I care about. My favorite art, if I were to collect or to show, of course, in the primary market would be art that addressed the Renaissance, the new ideas, the mysteries, the healing of the planet. But in terms of the secondary market is modern art, 1850, 1915. What I seek is to some people that are forward-looking, that have vision, but also that have a lot of soul and spirit, that are original, and that are good tests, also, essentially. In terms of originality, of course, there is sometimes there is like a Pissarro and a Sisley. There are some paintings you cannot decipher whether it's a Pissarro or a Sisley. You have to look at the signature because they are very, very much the same. And it's the same thing sometimes with Braque and Picasso. Georges Braque in 1910 was painting those Cubist paintings, and then Picasso was like coming to see, and then the next day he would make a copy of it, and he was like, "Whoa!" But Picasso was a genius. I love him. But Picasso was saying in his art, he was always saying that the master borrow from one another, but the genius they steal. He had really no problem on stealing from everybody. So Braque had to hide himself when he made new paintings, breakthrough paintings. He wouldn't hide it from Picasso, so he wouldn't make a copy right away. And what's ironical is that from 1910, for instance, those Cubist paintings, Braque is worth six times less than a Picasso. And actually, in time, I think it will be the Braque will be worth more. I think it's a better investment to buy a Braque that's for $1 million than a Picasso for $6 million or whatever. It's like from the same period. I do recommend. But essentially, Picasso in the beginning, in 1901, he was doing like Lautrec. After that, this blue and pink period was was inspired by the other Spanish people, the artists that were living in Paris. Then after that, the Cubist he was taking from Juan Gris, from Georges Braque, from Fernand Léger. And then after that, he was all the way to the 30s. He would take Demoiselle d'Avignon, and his African paintings were quite original. But after that, he would take from Matisse in the 30s those beautiful paintings, but they were very inspired by Matisse. I mean, I love them all, although Picasso, any painting of Picasso, for the most part, is great, even if it's like a copy of somebody else, he would copy it better. And so it's like, I'm not criticizing Picasso, it's one of my favorite artists, but it's like it's around the 40s that with the Doramar and those monsters of the war, the war inspired. I don't like care much for those particular paintings, but it becomes really Picasso. That's why we really see Picasso. And then from the 50s and 60s and then early 70s, all the late paintings are like completely Picasso explored so much in the arts. That's why he's so monumental. He's probably the most important painter of the 20th century. Although there is some people that are completely underestimated, I believe that Max Ernst is completely underestimated. Well, it's well known, but in relation, it's just as important, I think, as a Picasso or a Matisse or a Jeff Koons. There are certain people I don't understand really what's... or even Basquiat. Basquiat was like, it's fine, it's nice, I like this. Well, there are some that have a lot of hatred and heavy, but there's some really interesting things in Basquiat, but the price is like so completely dementia. It's like dementia. Or Jackson Pollock, it's like decoration. It's pretty, it's just very decorative, but it's not worth that much. We will find out in time. Right now, it's because the collectors are continuing to invest in those very high prices in those decorative paintings, but they don't have that much soul. And maybe Roscoe has got a lot more depth, or Barnett Newman a lot more depth in his. It all depends on the intention of the artist, what is the soul and the spirit that the art carries. So, but just everything is subjective in art. Some people will feel very good to have dead animals with blood dripping down the walls. It's like they like that. They feel joy by having skeletons around, everywhere around, like it's Halloween all year long, or like portraits of dictators like Hitler and Mao Zedong and Stalin and all those people, like, oh, well, I'm so happy I have this great art collection. It's like all those dictators looking at them. But in a sense, so it is not like there is no right or wrong. It is just a matter of preference and taste. And so just so that I talk a little bit about that, because I feel like very soon I'm going to be moving back into this this full-time job of working in the arts, on top of my own work, of course. And so, well, I hope you find this video interesting. I'm going to sing a song. It's about it's a song about being as light as a bird, to live like a bird, to be as free as a bird. It's a French song. And to let go of the problem of the world in order to be free, to tune into this frequency of spirit, in order to find the freedom within the now. And from there, we find all the solution. We find the way to harmonize all things, and everything will work out. Because if we tune in too much to the world is in great chaos right now, because it's the end of a cycle, and the powers that be needs to try to continue to control this world. But they will not be able to. It's like a desperate act. And so they're bringing the conflict to a next level. So do not let yourself be drawn in the conflict. Tune into your soul, to the love within your heart, and listen to this inner voice each and every day. This one, the song is called Fais comme l'oiseau. Do like a bird. Fais comme l'oiseau, sa vie d'air pur et d'eau fraîche, un oiseau, d'un peu de chasse et de pêche, un oiseau. Mais jamais rien ne l'empêche, l'oiseau, d'aller plus haut. Mais je suis seul dans l'univers, j'ai peur du ciel et de l'hiver, j'ai peur des fous et de la guerre, j'ai peur du temps qui passe, dit. Comment peut-on vivre aujourd'hui, dans la fureur et dans le bruit? Je ne sais pas, je ne sais plus, je suis perdu. Fais comme l'oiseau, sa vie d'air pur et d'eau fraîche, un oiseau, d'un peu de chasse et de pêche, un oiseau, mais jamais rien ne l'empêche, l'oiseau, d'aller plus haut. Mais l'amour dont on m'a parlé, cet amour que l'on m'a chanté, ce sauveur de l'humanité, je n'en vois pas la trace, dit. Comment peut-on vivre sans lui? Sous quelle étoile? Dans quel pays? Je n'y crois pas, je n'y crois plus, je suis perdu. Fais comme l'oiseau, sa vie d'air pur et d'eau fraîche, un oiseau, d'un peu de chasse et de pêche, un oiseau, mais jamais rien ne l'empêche, l'oiseau, d'aller plus haut. Mais j'en ai marre d'être roulé par des marchands de liberté et d'écouter se lamenter, ma gueule dans la glace dit. Est-ce que je dois montrer les dents? Est-ce que je dois baisser les bras? Je ne sais pas, je ne sais plus, je suis perdu. Fais comme l'oiseau, sa vie d'air pur et d'eau fraîche, un oiseau, d'un peu de chasse et de pêche, un oiseau, mais jamais rien ne l'empêche, l'oiseau, d'aller plus haut. Oh, oh, oh. Thank you for sticking till the end. Very soon I'm gonna start to sing in music. It's gonna be like so nice, like a bed of roses. But when you sing a cappella, it does not. It's really, really hard. But I've used that as a practice. I hope you don't mind that I'm practicing here. I hope you enjoyed those songs. For maybe soon I'm gonna be starting writing songs as well. And I think it's definitely something I see before me. So I wish you a wonderful day, a wonderful new moon. I hope this will bring this breakthrough for what we are all looking for, certain breakthrough. We have to let go of the past. We have to change ourselves. We have to be willing to change certain things within ourselves in order to project for the manifestation of our life to be projected in a different, to the reflection to be brought to us in a different manner. So let us not ignore this inner voice. Let us respond to the call and to stand to be counted, and then we'll be able to serve in such a most enjoyable way that there is a world of delight that is before us. I thank you very much. I wish you a good day. Namaste.